we will obey God rather than men. We're going to be faithful to the Lord, and we're going to leave the results to Him. Whatever happens is going to be what He allows to happen, but He will be on our side because we will be obedient and faithful to His word, and that is the unanimous commitment of our elders. And that means that we will continue to gather as a church every Sunday. Every Sunday. That is not going to stop. I don't know what might come down the line in thinking about the future, what and kind of restraints or constrictions might be attempted to put on us. We will be here. We will meet as the Church of Jesus Christ because we're commanded to do that. We will sing. We will pray. We will fellowship. We will proclaim the Word of God far and wide and even around the world through this live stream opportunity that we have. We've gotten affirmation from some pretty significant places. Some of the people that are significant in Washington want to come along and help us, some people with legal expertise on the Constitution. And so we don't know what's going to come in the future, but one thing we can promise you, we're having church at Grace every Sunday. We're having church, and we'll do what we can to be gracious to as wide an audience of people as possible so that people feel comfortable and they have some options where they can find that comfort. So know this, we love you, we love the Lord, we want to serve Him, we want to serve you. That's the joy of our hearts. I'm not nervous about this. This is not really a problem. This is an incredible opportunity. I feel like, this is the time in the kingdom for us to take a stand. I'll tell you what is disappointing to me is how few churches are standing up, how few large churches or even Christian leaders are willing to say, look, we're not going to bow to Caesar. We're going to serve our Lord. Churches are shutting down. Large churches shutting down until they say January. I don't have any way to understand that other than they don't know what a church is and they don't shepherd their people. But that's sad. And you have a lot of people in Christianity who seem to be significant leaders who aren't giving any strength and courage to the church. They're not standing up and rising up and calling on Christians to be the church in the world, as I said on Sunday.
So speaking of, I mean, obviously, there's just these different lanes that all these different churches are running to. You've got a church like yours who's saying we're not even going to gather together until, you know, the new year. Then you've got John MacArthur at Grace in California, where they're saying, man, our call by God, you know, theologically speaking, is to gather together as believers, even if it's against the law. And so talk to us about the theology behind it. Even down the street, maybe your friends at 12 Stone or Passion City or Mount Perrin, who maybe do co-laboring with you all year long, but they've decided they're going to run a different play. Or even someone to the extreme other side, like Pastor John, who's saying, I will go to jail for this because I feel like God's put a conviction in my heart to do that. Talk us through the theology of it, if you don't mind.
I am convinced that on the night that Jesus gathered with his apostles for his final Passover, that when he said, a new command I give you, I'm convinced that his new command is the marching orders for the church. This was the all-encompassing. It brings everything else up underneath it. This is the, if you forget everything else, remember this. He said, you are to love one another. And that wasn't new, to which he would have said, well, I'm not through. You are to love one another as I have loved you. Well, I think that is the driving ethic for Jesus followers. And that's why I teach constantly. And when you don't know what to say or do, ask, what does love require of you? Whether it's in your marriage, at work, at school, when you're not sure what to say or do, you ask, what does love require of you? So with that as this overarching Christian ethic, when it comes to a decision like this, I'm to ask that question in my marriage, we as the body of Christ who represent Christ in our community are to ask that for our community. What does love require of us? And here's what we always know what love requires. Sacrifice. It's a scary question to ask because it's going to cost you something every single time. So for us to make this decision on behalf of our community and then to use our energy, staff energy, and resources to invest in the community was our corporate answer to what does love require of us in this season for our community. So we think this is an expression of Christ-likeness, and it is costing us financially. It's costing us in terms of people who've left our church to go to another church because they want to gather on Sunday. I get all that. I'm never critical of people who make what's the best decision for their families. So we think this is the body of Christ being the body of Christ in our community. And again, I'm serious when I say this. I do not think there's a one-size-fits-all application, but I do think there is a one-size-fits-all theology and approach when it comes to what does the church look like in culture.
Yeah, I guess it's a different posture of like us against them versus us for them.
This is as you can tell, this is a big deal to me. Yeah. It's more than just an organizational decision. Mm-hmm. It is our opportunity to let our light shine in such a way that people see our church attendant. No. Let your light shine in such a way that people see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven.
Hey, Tim Frisch with A Frisch Perspective here. That was Pastor John MacArthur and Pastor Andy Stanley that you heard in those videos. And I just wanted to share those videos with you to show you the different perspectives that are being conveyed here by these two well-known pastors, and really just show you that not all churches are taking the same approach. I know a lot of the videos that I've shown, I've been talking about churches in California that are defying government restrictions out there and are meeting indoors, and a lot of you are really behind that approach and you feel like there has been a lot of government overreach. Pastor Andy Stanley has taken a softer approach. He's more trying to accommodate what the government in his area is saying. Now, it does make a difference where you live, and probably in that sense, it's going to change the way the government looks at you, the way that you look at the government. I'm sure that plays into it somewhat. But also what's being brought out here in these videos is just different theological perspectives. One of the things that clearly Andy Stanley emphasizes a lot is the concept of love and making sure that we are portraying love in what we do as Christians. One thing I do want to say, though, is that I really do believe that Pastor John MacArthur also believes in the command to love, but they really do have different perspectives on how we relate to the world, or as was talked about in that video with Andy Stanley, the posture that we have toward the world. And so really, I know a lot of you probably have different opinions, and you can talk about in the comments below. Just try to keep those comments constructive to conversation and edification. But I definitely think both pastors believe we need to be loving. It's really just a question of how do you best show love to the world, and how do you see the world in relation to the church? So those are really two things that are going on here. I also want to add, though, that I actually think these pastors are a lot more alike in how they're handling things than might first appear. Andy Stanley goes on to say in that video that his church actually is meeting in different ways. He does believe in the church meeting, and so he is accommodating, but he is actually having his church meet in different ways. So both pastors believe it is important to meet. Also, Pastor MacArthur didn't just go up against the government initially. He did try to accommodate what the government was saying, but then he felt that the government was being inconsistent, discriminatory, and unreasonable. And for those reasons, he actually brought a lawsuit against the California government. So both of them believe in the importance, the essential nature of church and the church meeting. Both of them have tried to accommodate the government, although in Pastor MacArthur's situation, it has broken down and he doesn't feel that the government really wants to work with them. And again, we're talking about different theologies here and the way that we look at ourselves in relationship to the world. There's definitely a difference in approach there that you can see in these pastors. So as I said, I'd love to hear what you think in the comments below. I just wanted you to see that information. I hope it's interesting and helpful to you. And as always, thank you so much for watching this video brought to you from A Frisch Perspective.